step in the club, looking fly with my crew, looking at me, tell me what you wanna do, looking for love. Welcome to this episode of Your Girl Talk. We're on the couch, and guess what we're speaking about?
Neciy.
Very interesting. Neciy?
Hey, you guys, it's your girl Neciy, Kimberly, Ashmin, and okay. We're going to be discussing gold diggers and sugar daddies. Ta-da-da-da!
Oh my gosh, I didn't think you were going to put me first.
Yes.
All right, then. So, you know, now it's trending. You know, everybody wants a sugar daddy. I've been seeing a lot of posts on social media and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm not sure what's the reason for that. I guess people want to live a certain type of lifestyle mm-hmm. that they can't afford for themselves. In the woman's case, that is.
Okay.
In the men's case, I believe that, you know, the older ones especially, because they're the ones who could afford to be a sugar daddy. They're well established on different things like that. And they are looking for attention. They are looking for someone to do things that their spouse or, you know, person at home would not do
mm-hmm.
with regards to freakiness and different things like that. Some of them just looking for attention,
okay.
You know, so it goes both ways.
But what are you guys' thoughts in terms of how popular it has become?
I just said it's basically trending. Everybody wants to live above their means.
Mm-hmm. Because before it was something a bit taboo.
It was.
You know, and now it's like mm-mm. people wearing these titles proudly, you know. I have a sugar daddy. Normal in public. I'm like, okay, you go, girl.
Kimberly, what are your thoughts on that?
Very touchy. I see it happening very openly now on social media. There are so many examples. I don't want you all to go digging in my friend list, but... there are so many of them that I see proudly. Mm-hmm. And I think that they are taking the sugar daddies to another extent because the sugar daddies are now getting sugar babies.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Wow. Okay. Wow. Okay. My thoughts on it, honestly. Wait. I'm going to ask you ladies this question. Do you think it's a genuine loving type of relationship, or is it that, okay, I know what I am to you, you know what you're, you know, once we both get what we want out of this, it's okay. Do you think it's like, I am in love with this person, I care about this person, I see a future with this person, that type of dynamic?
I think for me, what I have seen is that in the past, sugar daddies was hidden something, you know, you had a sugar daddy and he was giving you everything and you were going behind the scenes and giving him what he wanted in order for you to get what you want. But lately, I think the sugar daddies are, and the ladies too, they're looking for more out of it because they are now going out in public. You're seeing so much relationships coming out of the sugar daddies because men are now leaving their wives for these girls.
I personally think in some instances it's not always about actually having a sugar daddy. Sometimes these relationships evolve into actual relationships. You know, whereby people actually get hurt, family gets broken up, you know, new relationships are formed, as she said, you know, babies get involved and mm-hmm. different things like that. So different strokes are different folks, and some cases some of them actually evolve into relationships and strong relationships, mm-hmm. I may add. You know, it's sad, but it is what it is. You know, it's now a trending thing. It's now, I mean, there are some real gold diggers out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And it's...
But do you think that these so-called sugar daddies get into these relationships with these females thinking, knowing what it is, knowing
of course,
off the bat
of course.
What it is?
Listen, these are sensible men you're speaking about here. They have the money, they think they could purchase anything that they want. They know these girls and they're coming out now,
mm-hmm.
need things that they can't afford.
Okay.
Of course, so they're going to show that, listen, this is what I can give you, this is what I can do for you, they're taking you places that you can't afford, you know what I mean, things like that. So of course, they would know. And mm-hmm. of course, as I say, some of these old people are very, very freaky. Should I say old people? My apologies, because I have a lot of old friends. the more mature persons out there, the more mature men out there, you know, they're looking for, you know, a different kind of excitement, you know, and they're not going to get it with persons in their age group, right?
Okay, so who would you label as the wrong person in a situation like that. As is mentioned before, in cases where they have family and families being broken up and stuff, like, is it the gold digger fault for entering into this situation knowing that...
I would not throw blame.
You wouldn't throw blame?
The wives like to throw blame on the woman. Mm-hmm. The woman, I would not throw blame because it takes two to tango.
Yeah.
would never ever throw blame on a woman or outside woman. Oh, it makes no sense doing that.
Yeah, because I'm in a relationship with an individual. You see, if you open the door for somebody to enter, I can't blame the person for entering. I have to blame you for opening that door. So, I totally agree with it. Let's flip the script a bit in terms of, like, scenarios with sugar mommies. You know, like these guys out here gathering with these older ladies. Uh-huh.
Let me take it back one step. I would say I would not cast blame on one particular person. If I were to cast blame, it would be on the person who is in the relationship. For example, if the sugar daddy has a family and he's breaking up that family, definitely he is to blame. Like you said, he opened the door.
Yeah.
But in many of these cases, those girls or those young ladies know that these sugar daddies have families. They know. And they don't care. So then who do I cast blame? I do cast blame on them as well.
But we are not here to cast blame. We are here to speak about the topic at hand. And in truth and in fact, it takes two people to make a conscientious decision.
Yeah.
That this is how they want to go forward. In most cases, both parties know. In some cases, the woman don't know that the person is married. There are still cases like that on the rare occasions. But now everybody knows everything because Trinidad is such a small place.
Okay.
You know?
So let's go back to foundation. Do you think it's right for a female to entertain a relationship with a guy solely based on material things?
Of course not. Mm-hmm. No, why would
Because that's
be right?
where this whole dynamic started from. No, it's not an exchange right. of I love yous, it's an exchange of cash, you know, fancy things and things like that.
I don't think it's right. I mean, I would never say that it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I won't either say that it's right, because I feel as though it's an exchange of your body for material things, and I believe that your body is something that you should...
It's a temple.
It's a temple.
It's your temple.
And you should care about your body, and that's like selling yourself, almost borderlining on prostitution, in my opinion,
It's a polished term for prostitution, but it's basically the same thing.
It is basically the same thing.
Wow. And now in the cases, before it was more of a younger female versus older guy, now I'm seeing it flipped where these younger guys are going with these older women.
Yeah, we call them gigolos, I understand. Yeah, so now you have younger guys not wanting to work, you know, wanting to have the same experiences as, you know, a sugar daddy will give to his lady.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have older women who they call cougars taking care of these younger guys, you know, because they are being able to stroke them in the right places, you know?
Yeah. My thing about this is if two adults decide to make the conscious decision of going down that road and they don't have, like, families involved to be affected by it, your single young man or woman with a single older male or female, yo, pay up and do what you guys do. But
in a perfect world, that is what it would seem.
Yeah,
but really, not, actually, most of the time,
it don't happen like
involved,
that. Yeah, most of the times, it's a family situation where it's gonna people gonna be hurt, people gonna be affected by it. Yeah.
Kimberly, would you like to add anything?
So I think I'm not in support of it at all. Because I feel like in the case of gigolos and sugar daddies, there's sex happening and somebody's being sexually satisfied, which entails emotions being exchanged. However, in the case of gold diggers, somebody or the younger party more than likely is only doing what the older person wants because they want material things, they want money.
That is correct.
And that is totally different. Yeah. However, there is still emotions involved because the older person wants to be satisfied. So they are giving whatever the younger person wants in order to get something. But they are not realizing that they're only getting it because they are giving something. Yeah. So
I don't agree with what you're saying with regards that they don't realize. In some cases, this is an agreement that is made.
Yeah, it's understood. Both parties. It's understood.
You know, in most cases, rather, this is what it is.
But you know what I've noticed of lately? This is something that is now being expanded, not just to younger male or female versus an older male or female, but it's even happening within same age groups. For instance, you might be a guy working at a place where you're being paid nicely.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And you might be using that status to entertain females. In a sense that we're like, you know, it's not a relationship you're looking for, but because I could probably carry out on a date and should give you an experience that you're not accustomed to.
Right.
It's understood that, okay, I'm giving you this. At the end of it, you know what this is about. So it's not just a younger versus older type of situation. Sometimes like they might be same age. There's different statuses. And that's the exchange that's happening of lately as well.
I never came across any of those types, so I can't really shed light on that.
Okay.
Because in most cases, people around the same age group, I mean, you might be doing well, but they're catching the tail, mm-hmm. They could barely afford the things you have and wondering how you're able to do so.
Let's give an example. Probably like in the offshore industry or those industrial type of thing where guys are being paid handsomely, like in situations like that. Because I have friends who have had those experiences where guys approach them a certain way because this is where I'm working. So they flaunt with, they lead with, I could buy this for you. They know they're not looking for something more, but they think, okay, with the money comes that exchange.
Women need to have more control.
Self-worth.
They need to have more worth. They need to value themselves.
Yeah.
And not be so, get so caught up so easily in those type of things.
Yeah.
And
listen, if you're putting it out there that you can be bought, don't be offended when you attract only guys who are willing to pay. So I would like to end on that note.
That was a good
I'm fine. So I think let's wrap up and look out for more from Girl Talk.
Don't forget to leave your comments below and feel free to share the video. Thank you for joining us this evening.
Subscribe to our YouTube.
Hope you guys enjoy the show.